These are the 30 apps I need on every new Mac. And from the last time I made this video, some apps didn't make the cut. But I'm going to show you all the apps I use to record and edit video, post on all my social media platforms at the same time. Great Safari extensions, AI browsers like Comet and Atlas, clipboard managers, shortcuts extensions, the best app for framing your screenshots, and the first app makes this video possible, which is CleanShot X. I do a lot of screen recording in my videos, and CleanShot X is simply the best tool to do that. Not only can you capture still images or record your screen, but it has lots of settings, way more options, and more powerful than QuickTime. For instance, under recording, I can highlight clicks. It'll show an outline whenever my mouse clicks. I'll show keyboard shortcuts. It will also hide my desktop icons when I start recording. And once it's time to actually screen record, this part right here where you show me in picture-in-picture, I record that while I'm screen recording, so I don't have to overlay or mask that when I edit this video. I can choose from multiple microphone inputs, choose from multiple video inputs, click record, and as you can see, my desktop icon actually hit as well. The rest of this video, this is what you're seeing, the CleanShot X recording. And fun fact, you can get CleanShot X and four other powerful Mac apps with today's sponsor, AppSumo. With their new app bundle, not only do you get CleanShot X with their cloud subscription for a year, but you also get Paste, which is a clipboard manager and something I install on every new Mac. Every time you copy something in your clipboard, it gets added to Paste. You'll see here you can have text, links, even images. They're all saved. Paste will also sync across all your Apple devices, including your iPhone and iPad. The bundle also comes with Willow Mac, a great transcription software that you can activate just by holding the FN key on your keyboard anywhere on your Mac. It will start transcribing what you're saying. I like the little animation that it has in the notch so you know it's actually recording. As soon as I let go of that button, I get the transcription right away, and it can auto copy and paste wherever I am on my Mac. With Willow, you can dictate directly into Gmail, Notion, Slack, or any application, and it adapts to your accent, names, and more to make sure it gives you the most accurate transcription possible. You also get this beautiful Markdown writing application called Paper. This is it, no distractions, but you can still type in Markdown, whether you want to format that way or make lists. It's a beautifully clean application, and then you can take your writings, export it, save it as a PDF, HTML, rich text documents, or even publish it to services like your WordPress or Ghost blog. And as a part of that bundle, you also get the Roots Plus plan. This is going to help you block distractions and set limits on social media apps. It works with the built-in screen time settings, so you can set downtime or limits, like if you want only a certain number of hours on apps. And then if you try to open Instagram or TikTok during that downtime or limits, you'll get this message. You can, of course, set yourself to unblock, or you can get back some of your focus time, read, build better habits, use streaks, pause modes, and more. Normally, those apps are over $100 collectively, but with AppSumo, you can get them all for $39. Just go to appsumo.social/Steve, and you can get CleanShot X, my favorite screen recording tool, Paste, Willow Transcription, Paper, and Roots, all for $39. Once again, that's appsumo.social/Steve. That link is also in the description. My thanks to AppSumo for sponsoring this video. All right, now that CleanShot X is back running, Audio Hijack, it's what I use to record all the audio on my Mac, whether it's primary technology, my podcast, or videos. I've used it for years. It's the most reliable, most powerful audio recording software. You can do things like have levels in your menu bar, apply EQ, and even live stream from Audio Hijack. I'm actually recording the audio for this video with Audio Hijack right now over on my Mac Studio. When it comes to note-taking, Bear is the name of the game. I've done entire videos about why I use Bear, why it's powerful. I have it on all my Apple devices. It's a great Markdown editor, plus you can export in rich text, HTML. I use Bear for everything. Next, Transcriptionist is what I use to transcribe audio on my Mac. Every time I'm done with a video, I'll export the audio first because that happens way faster. I'll transcribe it here in Transcriptionist. I'll export a plain text version and give that to ChatGPT so I can ask it for title and description ideas. And then I'll export the .srt format to upload as subtitles to YouTube. Plus, I like that I can choose what brain to use when I transcribe. I typically go with the largest because it's the most accurate, and on my Mac Studio, it's still pretty fast. It uses OpenAI's Whisper API in the background, but because it's a native Mac app and you can use it on your iPhone and iPad, uses Core ML, so however fast your Mac is, that's how fast it could transcribe. Next, I'm not going to show each one in detail, but it feels like I have 100 browsers on my Mac now. Safari is still my default, and I'll show you a couple extensions I use in a minute, but I've been using Comet for certain agentic tasks. I have Brave to record in Riverside with primary technology, and ChatGPT released Atlas, their AI browser. It's not close to becoming my default browser, but I'm going to keep an eye on it. And while we're talking about OpenAI, I do use the native ChatGPT app on my Mac. I find it to be super fast, plus I still have access to my custom GPTs, like my custom Shortcuts GPT, which you can access if you support my community at create.beard.fm. But I use this every time I make a video or just for uploading images and asking it random things. I still like just the stock ChatGPT app. Also, I can't really talk about what I use this app for, but Downie is amazing, and the combination of Downie and Transloader, super powerful workflows you can do with both of these. I can't talk about what I do with them here, but check out my Shortcuts of the Week in my community because I show my whole Rube Goldberg setup using these two apps. Next is the app Croissant. Now I use Croissant more on my iPhone, but I like having it here on my Mac. This way I can quickly post to Blue Sky, Threads, and Mastodon all at the same time. You can connect those accounts and then even publish things like photos to all three at the same time with alternate text or image descriptions. Croissant makes it way easier to publish across those multiple networks. You already know Fantasitcal. It's how I do all my events and calendar stuff. Using calendar sets along with focus filters across my Apple devices, natural event input, Fantasitcal is the best. And I really like the convenience of having it here in my menu bar too. Next, let's talk about an extension real quick. I don't run a ton of Safari extensions, but I do have a few. Magic Lasso for content blocking, and I do use OverPicture. While the picture-in-picture features in Safari and macOS Tahoe have gotten better, I still like having the one keyboard shortcut where I can just tap the letter P, and any video I'm watching on any website goes into picture-in-picture mode. I can move it around, pop it back into the Safari window. I find that faster than clicking the little highlights button here, and then trying to find the picture-in-picture setting, which it's just not always there. With OverPicture, I could just tap the letter P and I'm in picture-in-picture. Next, if you want to frame your screenshots for sharing on social media, Shareshot is the best. I use it on my iPhone all the time, but I have it here on my Mac as well. And if I take a quick screenshot, Shareshot can find a screenshot from your devices. So this is from my iCloud library, or you can import a file. Like I'll just take the screenshot I took here on my Mac Studio. It recognizes that it was 27 inches, so it put it in an iMac. But then you can even decide what frame you actually want. So do I want it in an iMac 24 inch, 27 inch? It'll reframe it automatically. Then you can ask it to just give you a transparent background and export a PNG if you want to use it like in a video. Also, if you just ask it to choose a screenshot, you can choose any of the ones in your iCloud library. It recognizes screenshots. Oh, this is when Primary Technology was in the top 100 Apple podcasts last week. Then you can change the gradient style behind the screenshot, and you can run this in Control Center on your iPhone for literally one tap framing. Next, I use Pixelmator Pro every time I create a thumbnail, whenever I create custom artwork for Primary Technology. Pixelmator was actually bought by Apple a number of months ago. They haven't been updating it as frequently as before, but it's still super powerful. This is how I put together all my thumbnails, cutting myself out, cutting other things out. Pixelmator Pro is great. Now, I've actually been using the stock Reminders app for video planning in the Kanban view, but I still use Notion to collaborate for Primary Technology with my co-host Jason. We do all our show notes in Notion. It syncs perfectly. I can use the Notion app on my iPhone. Then I have the Notion app on my Mac, so whenever we're actually recording, I can refer to the whole rundown of the show. Next, and this app is key to all of my video production, and that's Gling. If you do any kind of talking head video like this is a talking head right now, Gling is incredible because you can give it your A-roll video and it's gonna cut out any bad takes and silences. I would not be able to make the amount of videos I make without Gling. Even this video I'm recording right now, I'm gonna put it through Gling. Cuts out bad takes and silences. You can always customize it with the transcript, put back a line, remove a line, and then I export a multicam clip to Final Cut so I can sync my B-roll, my screen recording from CleanShot X, and basically my A-roll is edited for me. This is a huge deal. I use Gling pretty much every day with every video. Next, I use Screens 5 to VNC into my Mac, either if I'm remote, so I'll use the Screens app on my iPad or iPhone, but I also have it here on my Mac. So if I want to access my Mac Mini that's in a closet running that secret workflow I was telling you about, I can do that right here. Oh, Screens has an update. I love the UI, great design, and it's rock solid, especially when I'm needing to access it remotely. When it comes to my tasks, things is how I do it. I have my video tasks here, podcast tasks here. I love the design of things, syncs rock solidly across all my Apple devices. No subscription, it's a one-time purchase. Next, I actually still use RSS to read a lot of my news, especially getting ready for Primary Technology, and I put all the RSS feeds here in Reader. I still use Reader Classic. I like the design. It's also super fast and solid. I use the Reader app on my iPhone and iPad as well. I just haven't found a better alternative that looks this nice, works this easily. Reader with two E's, thumbs up. Speaking of social media apps, I do have several natively here. I'm using Threads and Blue Sky in like the save the website as an app version. But when it comes to Mastodon, I do love the Ivory app. It's made by Tapbots, who used to make the app Tweetbot, and it's great. I use Ivory on my iPhone and iPad as well. Won't talk about these for a long time, but I use Final Cut Pro to edit all my videos. I use Compressor to export them all. I really like Compressor because I can have these groups of exports where I'll export an MP3 and then video file. All my settings are saved, and then I can just drag this onto whatever video I'm exporting. But a couple apps I use with Final Cut. When I'm editing in Final Cut, I'll drop markers for chapters. You'll see a little chapter marker right there. And for videos that I said, I'll link above. And then I use this app called Creator's Best Friend. And here I can drag my project to this window, and it pulls all the markers that I set as a chapter. This way I can easily copy this to my clipboard, paste that in my YouTube video description, and my chapters are done. Way faster than going in and manually typing or doing anything else. And then for the markers that I have as a video link, you can do that with Creator's Best Friend by going to Other Markers, and then it will pull all the non-chapter markers, like videos I set a link. But there's also an app by the same developer called Producer's Best Friend. And sometimes if I'm not doing it in the moment, I'll export an XML file of my Final Cut project. And then I can actually import an XML file that I exported from Final Cut. And this will pull all the information from my project and it'll put it into a numbers spreadsheet. So now I have a bunch of notes on the actual videos, but I also can export the markers so I can see what videos I said I'll link when with the timestamp. Makes it much easier to reference those timestamps later. Now, as soon as I'm done recording this video, I'm gonna put my audio through Isotope. Here I have several module chains. This one I use for all my videos where I de-ess it, use breath control, and add a little gain. I do this real quick before I import the audio to Final Cut and then sync that in the multicam clip that I got from Gling. Got it? Good. If you have any questions on that little process, let me know. Now, when it comes to brand colors, whether it's for my website or just colors I want to use elsewhere, I use Pastel. I love this application. Here I have my color save for my brand, which I'm not sure what my brand is. It used to be Bearded Teacher, but I just have my name anyway. Once you put in a color here, you can then copy the hex code, RGB value, and you can even drag images into a new palette. So if I drag a screenshot into Pastel, I can import, it will look at the colors in that image and then just give me the hex code values. And then I can save multiple palettes for multiple brands. If you're a designer, web developer, Pastel is a great tool to use. I still use TextExpander all the time, especially now with more prompts that I'm using with ChatGPT. You'll see I have prompts that I use, like when I have my transcript and I give it to the ChatGPT app. I use TextExpander to quickly put this prompt in there. I've used TextExpander for years, but now with all the AI apps and prompts that I want to reuse over and over, it's become even more invaluable. I've done some live streams and I want to get into it even more, and so I use Ecamm Live for all my live streams. Makes it easy to live stream to a scheduled YouTube video. You can do multiple streams, so one to Twitch, one to YouTube. I like that it's native, it's local, it's rock solid. Ecamm Live is great. Also, I use Callsheet on my iPhone probably the most. That's to look up movies, cast info, things like that. But I also love it here on my Mac. Little Easter eggs like clicking the runtime of a movie will tell you if you start watching right now, when it will end. You can hide spoilers, like don't show how many seasons an actor is in for a TV show. If you use IMDb to look stuff up, you should start using Callsheet. It's great. A little app I install called DataJar. This works with a lot of shortcuts behind the scenes. You can add values and manage it as a standalone app itself as well, but I use it mostly through shortcuts. For my Final Cut projects, I do use a lot of Motion VFX packs and M-Installer. And M-Installer makes it really easy to move those packs around. You can install each pack on two different devices, and then you can deactivate and reactivate on other Macs. M-Installer makes it easy to do all that. I do install Logic Pro on every new Mac because sometimes I have to open a Logic Pro file. My son's been recording some music, so we'll use it for that. And finally, this is a very niche app, but Companion. This is an app where basically, if you have a Stream Deck, which I have here on my desk, but you want to use it to manage a Blackmagic switcher, Companion can do that. Now, why wouldn't you just use the switcher? Well, the way I have my desk set up, my switcher is kind of out of reach, far on that side, and my Stream Deck is really close. But you can also do things like program picture-in-picture scenes and different things like that through Companion. And so I'll use my Stream Deck to manage my A10 mini switcher, and Companion is how I do that. Now, I told you at the beginning there were two apps that didn't make the cut on my new Macs. They're still great apps, and you still might want to use them for a variety of reasons, but one is called AI Actions. I used AI Actions to utilize the ChatGPT API in shortcuts. I use ChatGPT in a ton of different shortcuts, including things like Primary Technology. This is the Primary Tech Daily shortcut I use to curate the news every day. And where I was using AI Actions before, I've just been using the Use Models action now in macOS Tahoe and iOS 26. It's really reliable. I can still use the ChatGPT extension, and it's basically just taken the place of AI Actions. AI Actions still had some abilities that the built-in Models action doesn't, but for all of my use cases, the built-in Use Models action has worked great. And one other app I'm not installing on new Macs, but I still use is Hazel. Hazel is a great way to automate file and folders. I'm actually going to use screens to show you my Hazel setup on my Mac Mini, and I still use Hazel in this context. And Hazel is basically how you can have automated folder and file workflows. So when a file with this extension hits this folder, move it to this other folder. I was using that to do stuff with my Plex server. Again, go to my community if you want to learn more about that, create.beard.fm. But Shortcuts now has built-in folder automations, and it can do things like move files, even encode certain media. So I'm using the Shortcuts automations more. Hazel is still super powerful and does have some abilities like when you delete an app, it'll look through your library and application support folders to make sure everything is deleted when you actually want to delete that app for real. But I'm not sure how much I'm going to be using Hazel in the future because of those Shortcuts Mac automations. It's still an incredible app. It does have more powerful options and it's a little easier to use than the Shortcuts automations for the Mac, but I don't think it's going to make it on some of my newer Macs. But those are the 30 plus apps I use on all my Macs to get work done. If you have any app suggestions, and I know a lot of people want to hear about Raycast, if that's you and you want to see how I can use Raycast on a Mac, let me know down in the comments and get subscribed and hit that like button because that video and other app features will be coming up. I'm going to be featuring a bunch of iOS 26 apps that did liquid glass the right way. So that's coming very soon. Plus, I'll link my M5 iPad review video right up here. And this video, YouTube thinks you'll really enjoy. Thank you for watching. I'll catch you next time.